Yes, indeed, y'all. Yes, indeed. Welcome to UDR Productions. Please like, subscribe, and share. It doesn't cost you nothing to subscribe, so we can keep bringing you guys all this good content from prayer to streets. UDR Productions. Let's go and let's get it.
What's good, y'all? What's good, man? It's Jersey back in the building. I mean, welcome back, everybody. You know, last week we spoke about a couple of things. You know, back at Murphy's again, obviously. You know, this home away from home. Everybody would know me, so it actually is my home. But yeah, I just want to touch base back on what we spoke on last week a little bit about unity within our youth and, you know, more so our elders. You know, just, you know, get back to what might be the number one issue that we may have amongst each other. Thank you, young man. Appreciate that, dog. Like I said, I'm Matt Murphy, so you know, already know, gotta have a drink, get something to eat from my boy Signature later on. But yeah, so back to what I was saying. I feel as if the issues that we have going on with the, you know, youth, to piggyback on what I said, the lack of, well, the distance that we have amongst each other is really based off of, in my opinion, the lack of respect. And this past weekend, I actually learned that. And had that, well, I didn't learn it. I more so had a better understanding from my father. I spent a little bit of time with him, kicking it, working on our relationship, and trying to, you know, have a better understanding from someone that is my elder, you know, as someone who is younger. So being able to have that conversation with my father, he broke it down to me and basically was like, you know, today's youth and, you know, don't understand the fact that, you know, they don't respect their elders, which I do agree with. But also, you know, our elders don't respect the youth and what we're also trying to accomplish or what we're trying to do. And I think, you know, with that being said, we lost a lot of respect, you know, as me being a youth and, you know, people that's younger than me, maybe a few people that's older than me. You know, we lost respect because of, you know, daddy was probably never home, so we didn't have a male figure. Mommy probably wasn't home because, you know, she out working 2-3 different jobs, or mommy got a boyfriend because daddy ain't home. So, I mean, there's a multitude of different issues and avenues that you could, you know, speak on and we could follow. But when it's all said and done, I feel as if communication is the key to anything. So my biggest thing is, if you don't have any communication, whether you're young, old, a baby, it don't matter what it is, you know, there's always gonna be a disconnect. And you could speak on, you know, with communication on a multitude of things, you know, at work. If you don't have communication amongst your coworkers, if you're a manager, or even just another coworker to coworker, and no one knows exactly what's going on as far as, you know, whatever you're doing. If you didn't know a new shipment came in and, you know, you tell a customer that you don't have an item and the whole time it's sent back there, you know, that falls back on you and now you just lost commission. You can speak on school. If you don't communicate with your, you know, teachers on what you don't understand, how you expect to learn and get better in any particular subject. So it's a different amount of things that you can definitely use as far as with communication. And, you know, for me, in any relationship you have, you know, communication is obviously key. And, you know, if you want to speak on, you know, relationships, you know, a lot of people, you know, I wouldn't say people, just a lot of males in general have a lot of pride. You know, as a black male in this country, I damn sure got a lot of pride. You know, I love who I am, you know. So I'm definitely gonna be proud of who I am. So where do I find a way to connect with my significant other and let her know where I'm coming from without feeling vulnerable? And I think that's also a mindset that we also need to neglect and not focus on. I mean, no reason to sit here and focus on, you know, feeling as if you're vulnerable, you're sensitive. It has nothing to do with that. I mean, if you love the person you with, then you should be able to communicate with them, you know, regardless of what it is. I'm not saying pour out your heart and soul, start crying and, you know, boo-boo and all that. No, I mean, nah, just express how you feel. Like, yo, babe, get your ass over here. What are you doing? You know I don't like that. What is wrong with you? Like, come on. Like, you want me to do something for you, do something for me. Let's work together, because ultimately y'all have a goal in mind. You know, and if you love someone, then that's what you should be working on. And also vice versa, you know, not, you know, speaking on just the men, but from female aspect, stop nitpicking at things, man. Because like I said, me as a black man in this country, every day I step outside, I got a battle. every day. Like, I mean, just me being a black man is a battle in itself. I'm already, you know, target number, enemy number one. Like, you know, just me having any kind of, you know, my skin tone. Now, I know a lot of y'all gonna say my skin tone. Now, we can talk about that too. It's all right, you know what I mean? You know what I mean? I'm light skinned. I get it. Obviously, I'm brighter than the lights that's shining on me. Okay, I get it. I know. But at the same time, you know, I have black features. Okay, I am a king in my own right. So, you know, don't knock me. But, you know, females, stop nitpicking at certain things. You know, like I said, communicate with your man. You know, your significant other, whatever it is you prefer. I mean, communicate with that person and let them know what's going on. You know, just tell them how you feel. And you know, sometimes you might feel as if you're beating a dead horse. You might be upset and feel like, you know, oh, he don't ever want to listen. Well, maybe that attitude is turning him off. You know, why everything has to be a negative? Like, why not, you know, come whisper to him, you know what I mean? Come here, babe, let me talk to you, you know. You know what I mean? Do something nice, just surprise him. You might walk in the house, had a crazy ass day, and you just got dinner already made, like you had a dinner already ready, already like sitting on the stove, you know, or in the stove or in the microwave, whatever the case may be. And I'm sitting there, the door closed, he walk in, and you just sitting there in some lingerie. That's gonna turn his whole damn mind upside down. You're gonna be like, God damn. Forget what just happened. I'm about to go handle. So I mean, it's two sides to every story, obviously, and there's a lot of things that, you know, both parties can work on, you know. And like I said, whether it's young versus old, you know, relationship-wise, you know, male versus female, you know, why does it have to be a fight? Why do we have to, you know, go against each other? Why can't we communicate and work with each other? Like, I mean, it's so stressful and crazy, you know, fighting all the time. Like, no one should ever have to live that way, you know, regardless of who you are. Young, old, you know, male, female, you know. I mean, you can speak on a multitude of things. You can speak on race. I mean, why? What you hate me for? What is your issue with me? Like, I never do nothing to you. You know, if you want to, you know, speak on, I'll speak to the youth, people, you know, my generation, you know, younger than me. Like, don't hate me for who I am. I don't know you. You know, I'm just out here just trying to live my life, take care of me and mine. And I mean, you want to jump on a wave, let's go. Let's eat together. But don't never try to, you know, knock somebody for, you know, whatever they got going on in their life. I mean, that's one of the things we kind of spoke on last week too. I mean, touch base a little bit on that. But like I said, you know, life's too short as we can see. And I mean, anything can happen at any given time. You know, two young men just lost their lives over this weekend out here in Bridgeport. So, I mean, you never know. I mean, anytime is your time. So why waste it, you know, being upset, being mad, being angry, being, you know, just negative vibes. Like I said, bad juju. Don't nobody want to deal with that. You know what I mean? Smile, you know what I mean? Go grab you a drink, you know what I mean? Have some fun, you know what I mean? Life's too short. Just turn up and have fun. Just do it in a, you know, be mindful of it, though. You know, don't go around trying to be disrespectful towards anyone. Like I said, respect is a big thing for a lot of people. I mean, like I said, that could be, you know, based on gender, race, politics, religion. I mean, respect is, you know, big for any and everybody. I mean, show respect, get respect. And if someone don't respect you, you ain't got to retaliate necessarily. Just keep your distance. I already know what you about. I don't need that in my life. So I holler at you. I mean, it is what it is. Surround yourself around people that's trying to be better. You know what I mean? That's how I look at it. Always chase and surround yourself around people that, you know, are definitely doing something with themselves. Like, you know, I have a lot of friends that are, you know, older than me. You know, our family members are older than me. That's always passing knowledge to me. You know, even though, you know, I'm always acting like a little wild, crazy one out the cruise, you know, I am, you know, out here obtaining knowledge. I am listening to them and passing on to other people that, you know, are my age or younger. So, you know, a message is being sent out there. So to you out there, don't ever think that, you know, I don't listen. I mean, I can speak to my mom. I can speak about me personally. I mean, I'm not gonna speak on everybody else, just me so much. And, you know, my mom's is one of the most religious people ever. And that woman ain't never stopped praying for me. She ain't never give up on me. She's constantly telling everybody, you know, about me. And the things that I do positive, things I do bad too, all my negatives. But either way, she keep me in prayer, you know. You know, even though I don't follow her, you know, religion, so to say, but, you know, I do share a lot of her core values because, you know, that's my mama. So, you know, but like I said, I ain't going to touch on religion because, you know, a lot of people, you know, feel their way about how they feel. And, you know, I respect it, you know, and you're entitled to that. And I will never try to, you know, dismiss or, you know, like I said, disrespect anybody and how they feel. You know, that's not me. Wasn't raised like that, you know. Even though, like I said, you know, been there, done that little wild stuff and all that, been a hothead. So, you know, in and out of trouble. So, you know, but, you know, there's a way for anything. I mean, just keep your head up, stay positive. I mean, I'm out here, Murphy's, you know, just want to shout out to everybody, you know, that has subscribed, you know. Keep subscribing, pass the word along, you know, talk to people. And I mean, you see what I'm talking about, you see what my man M's talking about, you see what Mr. Smith's talking about. Come holler at us, man. We out here just trying to spread, like, I mean, love, peace, you know what I mean, positivity to everybody, you know. You gotta, if I offended you, drop a comment. Holler at me, those who know me. Hopefully you got my number. If you don't, hit me on social media. I mean, I'm always, come to Murphy's, come down here, join the show. I mean, I'm out here. Come holler at me. You got a voice, you got something you want to talk about? Come on down, let's talk, man. We all out here want to voice our, you know, opinions, our concerns. You know, if you have a personal issue, you want to, you know, talk about something, we get a second opinion on something, you know, you just want to talk about shooting pool, because we at Murphy's, we're going to shoot some pool later on when I'm done. We also talk about food. I'm a chef for a living, so I love to talk food. That's definitely a passion. We can talk family, you know, that's number one in my life. You know, other people got number one in their life, but, you know, while I'm here on this earth, you know, my family is priority, you know. What's good, bro? Everything copacetic? You good? All right. Just make sure you subscribe so you can see all the videos, all the shows, all right? You know what I mean? Respect, bro. You want to jump on? You got something to say?
Yeah, I do. I got a college radio station at Southern.
All right, well, you know what I mean?
That can happen.
Come on, jump on, sit down. Throw them headphones on. Throw the headphones on, bro. You got a mic, so that way you know we all can hear you.
Check, check. Mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2. We in the building, baby.
Yes, sir. All right, bro. So my name's Jersey. Now, I mean, what's your name?
I go by Surge.
Surge, respect, bro.
Nice to meet you, man.
So what's good, man? What you want to talk about, man?
Right now, you know, it's back to school, you know, fall season, everyone's going back to college, regardless of what's going on, you know.
Well, I mean, I'm not going back to college, you know. wasn't my really cup of tea, but, yeah. You know, yeah. I respect it, do what you gotta do.
Yeah, it's the college students, man, they're going back to school this year, you know, and I respect that because, you know, I just graduated last year. So, yeah, I was planning on going back, and I'm like, sheesh, you know, so much going on. And, you know, I represent Bridgeport, though, you know. I hold it down for Bridgeport. I'm originally from New York.
That's what's up.
I've been out here for a couple years now. I went to Housatonic. I graduated from Central. And then just last year, I graduated from Southern.
So what was your major when you was in school?
Graphic design. Multimedia, so, you know, I found a passion for, you know, the cameras, photography, the arts, and, you know, like, that's been my passion since I've been, like, 2 years old, man. My brother's, you know, he's into music, so that kind of helped me, motivated me a little bit to kind of, you know.
Yeah, they definitely mesh.
Yeah.
They definitely mesh right there.
And, you know, growing up in New York, it's just the vibes, like, you know, it's like the hustle, you know what I'm saying? Like,
Jersey, so yeah,
everyone's selling their CDs, you know, like, trying to make it happen, and it's like...
You're grinding, man, you always want, you're doing something better for yourself, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I mean, we all, well, not everybody, but even me personally, like, I dipped and dabbled and sold drugs, you know what I mean? But the name of the game is get in and get out. I mean, you don't want to make a career out of it because eventually, you know, they're going to come for you. So, I mean, just get in, get out. And for me, moving to Connecticut, like on my last show, I talked about, you know, for me, it was a humbling experience because it's a slower pace out here.
Yeah.
So, you know what I mean? But don't be wrong, they out here doing their little hustle, they grind out here too, you know what I mean? Everybody has their own way of doing it. A lot of people have, you know, choosing easy way of doing it. But either way, you know, the whole purpose of, you know, whatever you're doing is to better your situation.
Yeah.
So you going to school, I commend you on that, because school ain't for everybody. Trust and believe. And for you to have, you know, that passion, that drive to want to go back to further your education, I salute you for that, bro.
Appreciate it, man. And that's, you know, one thing my parents always told me is like, you know, we came to this country to have a better life for you, have a better future. So I was dedicated and I was disciplined to, you know, I got to go to class. You know what I'm saying? Like, I can't cut today. I got to be.
You got too much riding on it.
Yeah. So, you know, so for me to do that and make it happen for my dad, you know, he works in the kitchen. He's been in the kitchen for 25 years. And I'm like, yo, like, you know, I got to find a way out. You know, I got to find my hustle, find my passion, which is arts. And, like, you get what I'm saying? Like, just by doing that, you know, gave me the strength to finish school. It's not easy, bro. Like,
oh, nah, trust. There's so many. Listen, I was 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. Trust, a lot of my boys, they all went to school. I went to go visit them. You know, my boy after went to school out in Jersey, so it was easy to go visit him. My other boys went to school out in North Carolina, so, you know, went to go take trips out there and go see him. And the college life was fun. Don't get me wrong. I mean, it's your first time really away from your parents. And, you know, based on what you've learned from what they taught you, you know, you use that to, you know, be better. I mean, you take that information that they gave you and you just basically process that and try to utilize that in different situations that you come across. Because there's so many distractions and temptations. Trust, like I said, I've been to a lot of college campuses, so
I mean, party life, man. Turn up Thursday, it's not even Tuesday. Like,
what?
You're turning up from Tuesday, man, to Sunday, Monday. And
y'all probably only go to class on Monday and Tuesday.
Yeah, it was so many nights. I'm like, I don't even know how I'm in class still trying to, you know, keep it together.
That's how I feel at work. I be at work like, God damn, I need some water. I need a Gatorade. Like,
yeah,
I got work the grill today because I'm a chef too, bro. Oh, okay. So I've been cooking for 14 years.
Oh, okay.
So, I mean, that's my passion. You know what I mean? I grew up watching, you know, my grandmother's cooking, my aunts, my mother. You know, even like some of the males in my family, they dip and dabbled in it, you know, whatnot. But it was just actually seeing, you know, someone put forth so much, you know, passion and, you know, energy into just making something so simple.
Yeah.
But you see the outcome and it's so rewarding when you see how many people appreciate that meal and they enjoy it. So that's what's so gratifying for me. Like, that's what's satisfying for me. That makes it so much, you know, worth it. You know, being able to, you know, sit there and this is my creation. This is what I'm taking my time out to do. And you served at somebody and they get all the compliments and that is what makes it so beautiful. Being able to do something that, I mean, a lot of people can do it, don't get me wrong, but I found my calling, I found my gift, you know, something that I was good at. I mean, I'm good at a lot of things. They ain't that, you know, ain't that good, but
give it an effort though.
But at least I know for a fact though that, you know, is, you know, cooking is definitely one of my things. Like, yeah, you know, that's
and that's one thing that a female is gonna like when they know that a guy cooks. You know,
listen, I don't want to talk about females.
I'm just saying, you know, if you're going to chef it up, you know what I'm saying, they're going to expect that.
Well, yeah, definitely.
Know,
and knowing that I actually know how to, I know what I'm doing, that's the problem sometimes.
They're going to pull that card, they're going to be like, yo, you owe me breakfast, what's up?
This is me, listen, I'll do lunch and dinner, you get breakfast. All right, bring me some water, I'm tired of this. Out all night with your crazy ass.
Yeah. That's how I be though, man. You know, it's a love and hate relationship, you know, that's what it is, man.
It's funny though, I just really, right before you walked out, I just touched base on relationships. And, you know, what do you think is one of the most important things in a relationship? You know, give me your top two. I wouldn't even say three, I want to say three, but give me your top two.
I'm going to say trust and communication. That's it.
Right on. See, for me, I feel as if communication is number one. Because
yeah,
if you don't talk to somebody, how are they supposed to know how you feel?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I don't have to trust you because, you know, if you're communicating with me, I know what it is. I mean, if you telling me you out messing with this one, then it's up to me to stick around, but you communicated with me.
Yeah.
You know? So, I mean, that's just me. But, I mean, why do you feel as if trust is definitely, I mean, it's definitely up there. Don't get me wrong, it's in my top five.
Yeah.
You know? But why do you think trust is up there?
I think trust is up there for the simple fact that, you know, like, if she's going to hold it down for you, she's going to hold it down. You know what I'm saying? Like, to certain things that you're like, ah, she's lying. But if you know for a fact, you know what I'm saying, like, she gonna hold it down for me, like, you know, like there's no doubt about it.
You don't gotta second guess or you know, question anything about her motives or intentions, because you know what you've already experienced.
Yeah, she knows you're gonna hold it down at the end of both ways. And we gotta communicate, you know, like, alright. You know what I'm saying? Like, communication goes both ways as well.
Absolutely, absolutely.
You know, we gotta communicate to keep in touch what's going on. Alright, there might be times where, you know, you're busy, you don't pick up your phone, and it's like, you know, they wanna blow that proportion, and it's like, you know, that's not even it's not even it.
Well, nah, trust God, I know, because there's times when, you know, my phone lighting up and I'm like, God damn it, I'm at work. Leave me alone. I'm trying to make money. What are you doing? Like, you know where I'm at.
Yeah.
Like, shoot, even if I go out, it's like, yo, we got Murphy's Law. Everybody know that, no jurors. This my home away from home. So it's like, at any given time, you're gonna see me on that pool table with a drink or a beer, enjoying the music, enjoying the vibes. If I'm not feeling the vibe, I'll holler at you. I'll go to another little spot. I got a lot of spots, you know.
Yeah.
That's how I, you know, I'm from Jersey, so I stay on the move.
Yeah, I love Jersey, man. I fuck with the Giants, you know what I'm saying? That's my home, New Jersey, Meadowlands.
I was just watching that
East
game.
East Rutherford.
Man. Listen, I'm from Newark, and I was just watching the game. I was, like I said, I was with my father. Me and was out here politicking, catching up, getting real right, you know, me and him and our relationship and our mindsets, you know, like I said, creating communication now amongst each other. You know, which was beautiful. Like, for me, that was one of the best feelings ever. Like, you know, being able to experience that. You know, those individuals who know me, for as long as they know me, know the relationship that me and my pops had. So for me and him to be able to bond, to connect, was beautiful for me personally, you know, because, you know, we've always had our differences over the years. So being able to, you know, politic with him, and then right after we politic, you know, he speak his mind, speak my mind, go to Buffalo Wild Wings, watch the Giants get their ass blown out, you know, to like the third string 49ers, you know, what's cool? I mean, because like I said, he's a Giants fan, but I, you know, no disrespect to Giants fans, you know, because y'all play in Jersey. I'm a Jets fan, so we even worse than y'all. I mean, but we gonna talk about, you know, let's talk about next year. Let's talk about
next year. I mean, Barkley's coming back next year, you know, and it's like, it's just both teams are just suffering from injuries, man.
Well, yeah, that's what it is. I mean, we got young teams, they're trying to, you know, build both those offensive lines. You know, the defenses are not that bad. It's just more so continuity and everyone have an opportunity to gel together, you know. They need to get familiarized. It's almost like when you know you're dating somebody. You date them for a couple. Well, nowadays you date somebody for a week, and then you, next thing you know, they're pregnant and you get married. I mean, I don't know how that go, but you gotta give me at least 90 days. Like, you know, I feel like this is a work. Like, this is a job. Okay, so we got to sit here and figure out if you gonna pass and we gonna hire you permanently, because you start doing something. Listen, you're late. Alright, you messed up. Someone go by the. I got a 90 day
Netflix trial. 90 day Netflix trial. Sign the application, and that's it. That's it. We'll see, like, after that.
Yeah, after that. Make sure you send your email, because I'm gonna file. Make sure I'm gonna send you that bill. Trust and believe. That shit, $13.99. You go. Watch.
Make sure you have that A1 credit too. You check credit cards.
Shoot, you checking everything. I mean, that's always my motto, man. I mean, that's just, you know, ladies, no offense, all right? Don't get mad. Like I said, drop a comment. You know, it's all right. You want to cover my head, cover my neck, go ahead. I ain't mad at it. I ain't sensitive. Only on Sundays and Mondays, because, you know, I'll be trying to recover from my nights, all right? But outside of that, I ain't that damn sensitive. You know, I'm 5 days strong. I'm good.
Well, that's what's up, man. I appreciate the love, man.
Definitely,
you know,
man.
Downtown Murphy's, you know, it's the vibes. This is where it's at right now. You know, you hold it down for Bridgeport, man.
It's about to get even more lit. I mean, tonight on Wednesdays at Murphy's Law, they got karaoke night with DJ Slim. And it's always a beautiful turnout. We always got people from Stanford, Norwalk, you know, Bridgeport. We even get a few heads from Waterbury, you know, New Haven, wherever. As long as you come in with positivity, come through. Because we always gonna show love out here. That's what we all about. I mean, like I said, all the hostility and all that negativity, Man, leave that shit alone, man. We ain't about that, man. We gotta stick together, you know what I mean? We all beautiful people in our own right, own way. Physically, no, not all of us got it. I'm sorry, you know. Some of us are less attractive, but you know, there are people with beautiful minds. And there's nothing wrong with having a beautiful mind and a big, great heart. Okay? You know, you wanna say anything else to the people?
Yeah, man, stay motivated, stay hungry, you know what I'm saying? Dedicate yourself to what you want to do, you know, like, you got to find that passion within yourself, you know what I'm saying? If you don't push yourself, ain't nobody going to push you, man.
Definitely, you know? Definitely. And at the same time, to piggyback on that, man, don't ever be afraid to ask for help, man. I mean, you never know who may help you along the way. You never know. I mean, don't ever block a blessing. Don't ever block a blessing. I mean, because they all around. You just never know who's got one for you. So, I mean, just make sure you always, you know, stay awake. You know what I mean? Not stay woke. Stay awake. You know, open your eyes. Stay awake. Keep your mind, you know what I mean, open. You know what I mean? You never know what's coming your way at any given moment. I mean, I just joined this podcast last week, and I haven't known. I just wanted to shoot pool and have a couple of drinks. But yeah. Now I got me a show where I get to actually, you know, give my thoughts and opinions on a lot of different topics. And, you know, for me, that's been my blessing, you know, actually giving my opportunity to have my voice heard. So, you know, I appreciate it. And I mean, I appreciate you definitely stopping in. I mean, just showing love. You came to see what was going on, popped in, peeked. I definitely appreciate it, man.
Yeah, man. And that's just funny because that's how I got started with my college radio station at Southern. I just walked into the building. I was a freshman. And it was like, oh, we having a meeting. I'm knocking the door. I'm like, you know what I'm saying? Knocking the door, let me in, what's going on? There's a bunch of white folks, you know what I'm saying? Like, yo, you know what I'm saying? What you doing over here? I'm like, nah, I'm a new student. I'm trying to get with the program, you know what I'm saying? So I'm going to let myself in the door, you know? So sometimes, you know, if you don't make it happen, you know, it's like, ain't nobody going to make it happen for you. So
true,
I was at the radio station for about a good 3 years. I was working there. The first year I had to volunteer, you know, put in the work. Then after that, it was like, sir, you want a job? I got the job. I was promotional director, in charge of promotions, working with students, you know, getting interviews for artists. And you get what I'm saying? You got to be at the right place at the right time.
Yeah, I mean, definitely take the initiative. Like I said, also don't be scared to ask questions. Don't be scared to, you know, talk to people. You know what I mean? You can get help from anyone at any given time. You know what I mean? But, you know, Serge, you know what I mean? If you want to shout out your radio station right quick, we about to close out.
Oh, okay, yeah, College Corner Radio, man. We hold it down for Southern Connecticut State University. We broadcast worldwide, you know, on WSIN Radio, all the way from New Haven, Orange, Hamden, Woodbridge, Milford. It goes on and on, man. Worldwide, too, on the iTunes app.
New Haven County. You already know New Haven. Shout out. We all over. Man, shout out to Connecticut, man. Shout out to I ain't gonna say New England. We're gonna just say the old East Coast because I'm a Jets fan and I ain't got time for New England. I ain't got time for y'all.
Word, man. I appreciate the love though, man. Some good vibes, you know what I'm saying? We gonna keep this going.
Definitely, man. I just wanna shout out to everybody once again in Jersey out here. You know what I mean? My man Serge. I appreciate him jumping on. I mean, I just want to give a shout out to everyone that's out here, you know what I mean? Signature back there whipping it up. You know what I mean? Eleanor, you know, my ex-wife, because you keep acting up, you know. I miss you, baby. We have Murphy's Law, all right? Till next time, everybody. Peace and blessings and growth and prosperity, you heard?
Peace.
Definitely, man. I appreciate you jumping in, man. I definitely appreciate it.
I mean,
yes indeed, y'all. Yes indeed. Welcome to UDR Productions. Please like, subscribe, and share. It doesn't cost you nothing to subscribe. So we can keep bringing you guys all this good content from prayer to streets. UDR Productions. Let's go and let's get it.